First question, cellular totipotency is demonstrated by only gymnosperm cell, all plant cell, all eukaryotic cell, or only bacterial cell. So we know that totipotency is the ability of a single cell to divide and produce all of the differentiated cell in an organism. Many somatic plant cells, including some fully differentiated types, example, leaf, mesophyll, provided they contain intact nuclear, plastid, and mitochondrial genomes, have the capacity to regenerate into whole plants. This phenomenon is totipotency. So, correct answer for this question is all eukaryotic cell. Okay, so correct answer is option C. Next question. Parasexual hybridization means. So, parasexual hybridization is a non-sexual mechanism of transferring genetic material by fusion of cells of different characteristics. Protoplast fusion technique is used for hybridization. Protoplasts are cells without a cell wall. The absence of cell walls helps to overcome barrier for fusion. Fusion of somatic protoplasts of two plants can be achieved mechanically or by using chemicals fusogens. Somatic protoplast hybridization is the only way through which two different parental genomes can be recombined among plants that cannot reproduce sexually. So the correct answer is option C, that is fusion of somatic protoplast. Moving towards the next question, genetic engineering is possible because. So genetic engineering is possible because all organisms are based on the same genetic code. DNAs which act on specific position or sequence on the DNA are called as restriction endonuclease. The sequences which are recognized by the restriction endonucleases are restriction enzyme, are called restriction recognition sequence restriction site. These sequences are palindromic sequences. Different restriction enzymes present in different bacteria can recognize different or same restriction site, but they will cut at two different points within the restriction site. No two restriction enzymes from a single bacterium will cut at the same restriction site. Thus, the correct answer is option D, that is restriction endonucleases purified from bacteria can be used in vitro. So, correct answer for this question is option D. Moving towards the next question, it shows correct chronological order of the events occurring during callus culture. So, callus culture is the formation of new plants from few cells obtained from a desirable plant. A small piece of the plant is taken and placed in nutrient medium. This small piece is called explant. The explant then undergoes cell division to form an undifferentiated mass of cells called the callus. The callus is then added with cytokinin to acquire meristematic activity, or so the solution is, or the correct chronological order is explant, so it's there in option B and C. Then we have cell division, so it's there in option C. Then callus, then addition of cytokinin, then cell acquire meristematic property. So correct answer for this question is option C. Looking towards the next and the last question, that breeding of crops with high level of minerals, vitamins and proteins is called. So it is called actually biofortification. Biofortification is the idea of breeding crops to increase their nutritional value. This can be done either through conventional selective breeding or through genetic engineering. It differs from ordinary fortification because it focuses on making plant foods more nutritious as the plants are growing rather than having nutrients added to the food when they are being processed. So correct answer is option C, that is biofortification.